Hello, I'm Alex Karekas, and I want to welcome you to my Finding Lost Civilization series. Today, we're in the state of Nevada, and we're near a town called Alamo, which is off of Highway 93. And we're in a place called the Famagrant Valley. It is a desert area, except this little valley is an oasis. Climbing up this hill, I ran into a deer. We surprised each other. So this is why people lived here. There was water, there was life. But I'm going to show you something right behind me, which is absolutely fantastic. Let me zoom on you. Okay, I'll bring you on in. This is Juan Pedro. Okay. Now part of it's been lost through time, but let me show you this right over here. I'll tell you, right here. Look at that. Isn't that fabulous? Those are hands. Okay, up here, there's the arm. Well, there's where the head used to be, and through time, it wore off, okay? We'll come back down. Okay, we're coming back down. Look at this. Here are the feet. Here are the feet. Now, you probably can hear traffic going by. You know, the interesting thing about this area is that a highway runs in between these two hills, okay? We're on a hillside here, and there's another one on the other side. So this highway, Highway 93, follows the path of the ancients that used to live here. It's interesting how sometimes our modern highways were also used by the Indians. So between these two hills, these two mounds, so to speak, there used to be a path. There's a little stream down here, and what they did was built a freeway right there. You probably can hear the vehicles going by behind me. So there we have a convergence of the old and the new, you know, a new highway with an old path. But definitely over here again is evidence of a lost civilization. So this is fabulous. We're going to spend a couple of days here, and I hope to show you more sight and let's continue our trek to find lost civilizations. Well, we're coming up to the figures over here, and as I said, I can tell they're what they call anthropomorphic. In other words, they're human figures. This is really great. Look at this. This is what I find so interesting about these petroglyphs. Look at the hands over here. There's another set of hands and another set of hands. So let's stand back and take a look. There you go. Let me turn it sideways. That's beautiful. And look at this figure over here. Okay, but look at this. There's two. These are probably deer from this area, okay? Yes. You know, you'll find a lot of these petroglyphs near water sites, okay, near places where hunts took place. So after the hunt took place, the warriors sat around and told stories. They ate their food. Shamans were here. They had their fertility rites here. It was a center of life because this is where food was. Now right over here, right over there, is a stream bed. And yesterday when I walked that stream bed, I walked upon a deer. So I know that this is a good hunting place, this little area. And over here in the corner, it's called a wildlife refuge. So this area has a lot of water, sustaining life. This is beautiful. This is why they were here. This is where they celebrated the hunt. Oh my goodness, look, I just saw something right over here. Look at this over here. Very faint. Very faint, but again, it's a drawing of a deer. So, I'll tell you, this is always fabulous to find these. We'll continue. Oh my goodness, here's another one. Look at this. This looks like a bighorn. Okay, the bighorn sheep from this area. Now, this could be a warrior representation here. See this right over here? They've had similar symbols on the other side of here, and this would be the Alasal. Well, we're continuing our walk. There's a little trail over here. So, you know, people have come here for many years to view this rock art. And my goodness, right here, here's a symbol right here. Now, I want to tell you something about this symbol over here. There's five symbols that are common to all cultures in the world. And you'll find these symbols in Australia and Europe and here in America, all over the world. One of the symbols is this dotted design, just these dots. Another symbol is just a wavy line, okay? Looks like a snake, but it's just a wavy line. And another symbol is the spiral. Now, I haven't seen the wavy line with the spiral here, but definitely this is one of the five symbols that you'll find in all rock art throughout the world. Well, there's a view. This is the west side of the hill. Right over there is a freeway. And right over there is the east side of the hill. Let me show you what I found over here, and this will give you an indication of how old this site is. Look at this over here. This right over here is what they call the Alatal. Okay, let me see if we can get a better view. Okay, right here, it's very hard to get. Let me see, the Alatal. Okay, there it is. It's a crook right here with another little crook here. This here represents a stone, a weight that's on the Alatal, and this predated the arrival of the bow and arrow. And what they did was they took the Alatal like a sling. They held it over here, and when they saw something, they fired it. There was a projectile right over here. And look at this, next to the Alatal is a symbol. Could be a man with an Alatal, a hunter with the Alatal. Now the Alatal preceded the bow and arrow. So this petroglyph is very, very old. I'm not talking 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 years ago. This petroglyph could be well over 1,000 years old, if you can imagine. A great find, and it's really a beauty. It's in really pristine shape. It hasn't been defaced. Well, there's a traffic right there. So let's continue our quest. This has really been great. You know, there's symbols up here, and this is what it's all about. It's hard work. You got to be careful so you don't slip, fall. There's snakes out here. So you have to go slow, you know, and keep it... Well, as I mentioned before, we're very lucky today. There's a slight, you know, cloudiness here. So this cloudiness, okay, gives us a shadow, which is perfect. If the sun was out, you know, the rays would be bouncing off these rocks and we wouldn't be able to get good images. So we're very lucky. Right behind me is a beautiful, beautiful petroglyph. Isn't that beautiful? Look at that. Let me come up closer here. There over here, there's his head right there. That's his head. We're coming, there's his shoulders right over here. And we're coming down. There's his hands. Okay, right up here. You know, representation of a man. Again, there's the shoulders. There's the neck right here. And then there's the head. very old, as you can see. Part of the stone is decaying through age. But we're fortunate to be able to see this here. Let me step back a little bit. Now the sun's trying to come out, so it's going to be difficult here. But there it is. Let me go slowly up. There you go. Let me point out to you again the multi-representation of the symbols here. Right over here, we have what I would consider a warrior out on his hunt. There's the Alatal. And as I said, these places are used to commune with the gods, fertility rites, and to commemorate the hunt. Right over here, you see the representation of 1, 2, 3, maybe 2 deer. You can see it. And right here is a fertility symbol. So we have all three things that basically we've talked about. We've talked about the hunter, we've talked about him celebrating the hunt, and we've talked about the fertility symbol. So they didn't have any written history, but maybe they put it right here. This is their history right here. The rock art tells the story. This is not a bunch of blabbering, it tells a story. This was a great site to hunt, okay, a great site to have fertility rites, and a great site to commune with your gods. We chone, we chone, we chone, we chone.